Hey gamers, this is Liz Davidson from Beyond Solitaire, and today I'm going to be reviewing A4 Quest from This Troy Games and Board & Dice. A4 Quest started its life as a free print and play that you can still get on BoardGameGeek, and it now also exists in a print version that was kickstarted by Board & Dice. It is basically a very simple dungeon crawl adventure that is guided by rolling dice and then taking actions using those dice to power them. For each adventure, you're going to choose a character. So Greybeard is our more standard starting character, but there are a few in the box. You also pick what adventure you want to take. So this is first Journey into the Abyss. But what's interesting is that each of the adventures has slightly tweaked actions and things that you can do with your dice. So every adventure is just a little bit different, but they all have the same basic mechanic, which is that you are moving from room to room to room, and you're spending dice to take actions there. Some things are not optional. For example, you must pay a die of a certain value to move at certain points. And if you can't pay it, you have to reroll a die and lose health. You also must encounter monsters. And so you need to be portioning your dice out to make sure that you're prepared for those encounters. And of course, you're going to end with a big epic boss fight. And throughout the journey, your stats are going to be able to increase or decrease. So your attack, defense, health, food and like different treasure and experience values are all tracked over here, and you adjust them as you play the game. So basically all you do is you roll 4 dice. So that's not the most amazing roll, but actually no, 3 fives is pretty good. So once I rolled these dice, I would use them to take actions. So starting in this room, I could choose to hunt and get more food, which you use to rest and recoup dice that you've spent. You can go on a quest, you can search for treasure, and then you'd have to move to the next room. So if I wanted to, say, hunt for 5, I would spend this die that's worth 5, put it in the used dice area, and then take 2 food because that's what you get when you hunt with 5. Then I would have to spend a die to move to this next room, a die that is 2 or greater. I could choose to do something in here, and then I would have to move here and encounter the monster. When you run out of dice, you have to take a rest action, which costs you a food but allows you to re-roll the dice that you spent. And the goal is to try to survive all the way to the end of the sheet. Sometimes you get unlucky and you just get bad die rolls, especially when it comes to monsters, because you roll to see how powerful the monster you're going to fight is. So you roll an adventure die to see if you fight a less intense monster, or perhaps you get a 6 with a large modifier and you fight a monster that's a 9 power monster that has special abilities and really messes you up. So part of the game is luck, and then part of the game is choosing how to spend your dice in a way that is going to be the most beneficial in the long run, and that is going to help you get where you need to go. And you can always see a few rooms ahead, so you at least have the ability to plan for upcoming choices and turns. There's a lot to appreciate about A4 Quest. Although the game has spent most of its life as a print and play, it's definitely a passion project, and a lot of thought has gone into its development, and especially into its art style. You can see a lot of love in the art, and it's very aesthetically pleasing. I also appreciate the little tweaks that different characters and even the companion animals can add to the game. So although the game follows basically the same pattern every time you play, each level offers you different ways to use your dice, and each character has slightly different starting stats and little tricks up their sleeves that make it feel legitimately different to play them. And the game gets further variability when you add in the companion animals. So even for a game that could feel repetitive, I'm impressed with the small changes in design that give it a little bit of variability. That said, I'm not convinced that A4 Quest is flavorful enough for me, and here's why. I think for me the biggest issue in A4 Quest is that this is a game about advanced planning, and the first few times you play it, the game is new and exciting and you're learning how all the different actions work and how you could use your dice, and it's actually a lot of fun to plot out how to use them. However, the first and second play feel really different from the 10th, where you basically know what you're doing with the adventure, and once you roll your dice, it's almost a foregone conclusion what you're going to do, because you've learned how to plan ahead in the game, and so you already pretty much know what the more optimal choices with your dice are going to be. And then that feeling of kind of already knowing what to do makes the game less exciting, because you know you're no longer making exciting decisions or scratching your head about what to do. You're just doing something that you already know is going to work. And my last criticism of A4 Quest is that it just felt like I played the game out a little too quickly. And it makes sense. A4 Quest was originally a PNP. It was designed to just be printed out and played. You know, it's a fun little game, and I did enjoy my plays of it. It's perfectly charming. However, there's a certain genericness about the adventures and about the characters, even with the little tweaks that the designers put in, that kind of make it feel like you've played it out too quickly. So even though there's some stat differences between your characters, they're all pretty standard fantasy characters. You don't really necessarily feel a strong sense of progression with them because the main goal of the game is just to survive to the end of a page. So it's entertaining while you're doing it, but it's also not necessarily an experience that's going to leave a big mark on you as a gamer. So again, while I enjoyed my plays of A4 Quest, I don't really think it's a keeper for me in the sense that it's something that I'm going to want to pull out in a month, in 3 months, in a year, and experience all over again. So while A4 Quest is a perfectly charming game, and the price is right if you decide to download it as a PNP instead of try to buy a print copy from Board and Dice, I'm still going to give it a 6 out of 10, because while playing it was perfectly pleasant, I'm not convinced that the game has staying power. So that was A4 Quest, a quick dungeon crawling PNP. Happy gaming!
Thanks so much for watching another Dice Tower video. If you enjoy our videos, subscribe to the channel for more fun, comprehensive board game coverage. Also, consider joining us at one of our events. Come to Dice Tower Retreat, a small, intimate gathering where gaming is king. Join us for Dice Tower Cruise, the largest board game cruise. Attend Dice Tower West in Las Vegas for gaming fun on the West Coast, or Dice Tower East in Orlando, in sunny Florida. Dice Tower Conventions, the friendliest gaming conventions on Earth. I'm Eric Summerer, and you've been watching The Dice Tower.